Alright, so Guinea-Bissau, a country many people don't even heard of. A very small nation, deep in Africa. That's the country I would like to talk about today, because last week a friend of mine contacted me. I'm still keeping in touch with my African friends, especially they're reaching out since they don't have many European friends. And he told me that his father passed away. In fact, my friend from Senegal, who introduced me the friend in Guinea-Bissau, told me that his father passed away. But he deleted his Facebook account, so I couldn't contact him. Anyway, he should also have a couchsurfing account, because I helped him to become a couchsurfing host. Since there are barely people knowing couchsurfing down there in Guinea-Bissau, and I was his first guest. Unfortunately, I had a bad experience because the people are very, very poor. It's one of the poorest nations in Africa. The life expectancy in Guinea-Bissau is only 57 years old. That's the least I've ever heard of in the country I've visited. There are probably poorer nations deep in Africa, but this is probably the poorest country I've ever visited.
The first day I've been to Guinea-Bissau, I had couchsurfing. A very nice guys, environmentalists, and he took good care of me, but the house was very run down, very old, but it's like the locals live, which is okay to have this experience.
But I was still grateful that he hosted me. They haven't had running water, for example. The sisters have to go to Duel and get the buckets with water so we could take shower.
So the pigs are bathing here. And this is just the gym, next to the pigs.
It was it were extreme conditions, and the bad experience, it was not about the living conditions, it was about that one of his brothers, I assume.
Their brothers or somebody, they stole money from me again, like this is the second time. Here it happened the first time, but it also happened in Gambia.
Stole money from my pocket. Yes, I took all the valuables mostly with me, but I left, for example, euro emergency currency, 40 euro in my bag, and yeah, it was gone after I got back from a trip. And it must be one of his brother, because he shares the room with two of his brothers only, yeah, and usually they lock the room, so it must be one of them. Although I didn't want to disturb them, so I didn't mention it to him. Anyway, Guinea-Bissau. Guinea-Bissau is on the west coast of Africa, using the West African fro, which is the same currency. I think other nations as well use it, for example, Senegal, and I don't know the other nations there, like Burkina Faso, I've read. And yeah, so it's easy, you don't have to change your currency when you come from Senegal. In fact, I came from Senegal overland, because I was in Ziguinchor and it wasn't too far, so I thought I'd just visit the capital, especially because my friend from Gambia introduced me to his friend in Guinea-Bissau. He is an environmentalist, he's a radio moderator, so he even been to Europe on a trip sponsored for some charity, I don't know exactly. So it was very interesting. I accompanied him to the radio, where he gave speeches, and also, yeah, to see local life. First of all, people there speak Portuguese, because it used to be a Portuguese colony. And I think it became independent in 1974, so less than 50 years. Yeah? So in fact, the country is less than 50 years independent. And yeah, what to do in Guinea-Bissau? That's a good question, because there are not too many tourists. So besides visiting the local culture, seeing the language, and trying some local food, I asked my friend what I can do, and he said, yeah, deep in the jungle, he knows somebody who is taking care of, he's also an environmentalist, so I could visit his friend. He couldn't speak English, unfortunately. So I took the bus to another city called Buba, I just looked it up before, yeah, because I forgot it. And there I got hosted by the camp, by the facilities of the environmentalist camp. So I spent there 2 nights, also harsh conditions, but it's an experience. Yeah, it was beautiful though, yeah, to see, and I think the people there, they never see a wild guy, yeah? Like, well, rarely see a wild guy. So it's nice that people are just curious, they're making friends, they're very friendly. It was interesting, you know, I enjoyed the fame being down there deep in the jungle. Yeah, so I accompanied his friend as the environmentalist worker to see what he's doing, and they having had a chimpanzee in a cage.
Boo. He likes to drink water, but I don't want to give him my bottle, you know, I want to drink it later on. No, you come here. He wants the bottle. No, you come here down. You come down here, and I put it in your mouth. Come here. Yeah, that's how you drink it.
Yeah, that was one of the most highlights, although I felt heartbroken because this tiny cage accompanying the chimpanzee, and it's interesting to get so close to the chimpanzee. Chimpanzees can be dangerous, but only if you provoke them. So I asked them if they could let the chimpanzee out, so I could get a close encounter with the chimpanzee, but they said no, he would run away. I said, okay, instead, can you let me in? I said, okay. So they let me in this tiny cage, and I had a wonderful, unforgettable interaction with this little chimpanzee, probably the highlight of my entire trip.
So, we're here in the cage, and he'd like to play. Hey, boo.
I spent a few minutes, maybe 10, and it was such a friendly chimpanzee. I love this guy. Yeah, but besides that, there's not too much to do. You can pay expensive tours to the see the environment, see the animals, especially birds. Yeah, they're not lions or anything. Chimpanzees, they have chimpanzees there, but I haven't seen any wild chimpanzee. But I thought, I wanna explore the wildlife, and it's very difficult because of the transport. So the environmentalist friend said, "Yeah, you can rent me a motorbike."
It would also be nice if you could rent like a motorbike, and we could at least get around this town. But so far, it seems really nice here.
Yeah, so it was like a cross bike, very old one. I paid them like $10 for a day, plus the gas I had to fill up. And so I took a tour into the national park.
So now we're here at the motocross in the national park.
It was very interesting to see people, they're getting the cashew trees. So you have cashew fruits on the way.
So here we are at the cashew fields. Yeah, as you can see here, delicious cashews. Yeah, and because now is the season, so now the time is perfect, right, to collect them. Yeah,
and you can really explore the little villages inside. And, although they're wearing more like Western clothes, they have a very strange setting. Yeah, they're not really. They're excluded, but they're still kind of civilized. Every shop has like a kiosk, yeah, like maybe tiny restaurants and little huts, church, stuff like this. Yeah, so the highlight was like they could just take the motorbike and just ride the dirt roads into the jungle. It was really fun because the roads are really bad, but with this cross bike it was fun. And I really enjoyed myself on this day trip. I checked Google Maps and I planned a round trip. And at one point there was a river and no bridge. you know? And then Google Maps said there is like a way, a bridge, but there wasn't a bridge. And I said, shit, I can't go back. I will not make it on time. It will be dark. I have to sleep there somewhere in the village. And then luckily there was a boat, yeah? Although it was a tiny boat, yeah? So they had to put a ramp and take my motorbike onto this tiny boat to help me cross to the other side.
It's a motorbike on the small ferry. It's amazing how you can carry a motorbike with a small boat.
But luckily I made it, so I could go back to the city in town. Also, there was a hitchhiker, you know, I'm tired from driving. So he also wanted to go to the city, Buba. And so I let him drive in the end, and it was really cool that he was really fast. It was crazy. I thought we were gonna crash. But everything was fine in the end. I had a wonderful trip. So I made the best of out of my Guinea-Bissau stay. Afterwards, I returned back to the capital, Bissau. But it was very difficult because the buses just leave when they're full and it takes ages.
So this is the Buba bus station, and it's very difficult to catch a bus because people don't speak English and buses leaving to everywhere but not to the capital.
Yeah, I tried like a private taxi, but it also didn't go. It was the conditions there are just harsh, and then it was really hot. There are no windows in the bus, no air condition. But eventually made it back, and then I stayed, I think, another night at my couchsurfing friend. Yeah, so I actually, he wasn't into couchsurfing, but I think now he have hosted some people. So Elton, yeah, is his name. So I stayed a few more nights, and then I went back to Senegal. Yeah, so that was my Guinea-Bissau trip. Just want to keep it for the memory. And yeah, in case you're gonna visit, it's a very, very special experience. Thanks for watching.